Started playing the piano when I was 3 years old. That's all I've ever done. I've never had a real job. Never had a chance my whole life to say, you want fries with that? And I praise God for that opportunity. Started playing when I was three. But when I was 8 months old, I was learning how to walk. And I had one of those little walkers that you go around in the house. And I ended up in the hallway one morning, and there was a floor furnace heater in the hallway. One of the wheels of my walker got caught in the grill of that furnace and turned over. And both of my hands landed right on top of that furnace. I had third-degree burns. I was carried on a pillow for a year, had three medicated baths a day for a year and a half. The third-degree burns. Doctors said I'd never be able to move my hands. But I can. And I'm so glad that I can. There was one doctor that said I couldn't, and another one that said I could. I like that. Hey, that's pretty good for a Baptist. I may be Baptist, but I still believe in the healing power of Jesus Christ. Came home from church one Sunday, and the choir sung a song one morning that I never forgot. I couldn't wait to get home and see if I could play it. It's the first song I ever played. After picking my mom and dad up off the floor, we started looking for piano teachers. Nobody wanted a three-year-old for a student. I've had a three-year-old. I know exactly why they didn't take me. But they looked and finally found a place over in Chattanooga at the Shoddy Conservatory of Music. I was enrolled at the conservatory there at the university at the age of five. At the age of six, I had my first piano recital. How many have been to a piano recital? Aren't they a blessing? That was the worst night of my life. I was 6 years old, scared to death. I couldn't even reach the pedals. I can't hardly reach them tonight. But we had a big 9-foot Steinway concert grand there on stage, and it was a bad night for me. Four or five years later, my teachers came to me and said, Anthony, it's time that you learn some real music, the classics. Picked me up at the conservatory, and she had the radio on in the car, and I heard this guy on the radio from Nashville, Tennessee, playing the piano. Changed my life. I loved the way he played. I went home and practiced and practiced, got all his records and practiced, and I wanted to be that guy. I wanted to make records. I wanted to play like him. Where are you going, son? How old are you? Seven,
I got a 6-year-old. You comfortable? Anybody else want to move? But this guy was great. I always wanted to be this guy. Floyd Kramer was great. I loved the way Floyd Kramer played the piano, but I was getting a little older and wanted to be cool. Floyd wasn't real cool. But this next guy I saw on TV I thought was cool. Through all different styles of music growing up. Everything you could imagine, I would try to learn and try to play. My mom threw away so many records, 8-track tapes, the ones she didn't want me to learn. But Dad said I could hear it one time and play it, so I'd already learned them. It was pretty scary in the 70s.
Yeah.
But it didn't matter to me. It was just music. It just different styles. I wanted to learn everything I could learn about music until I got saved. I got saved when I was 9 years old, and that's when I started making a joyful noise with a piano. Became the church organist at the age of 10. I'm a Baptist. It took a year to get it through the committee. But they finally passed it, and I played the organ. My dad played the piano, and we would play it every Sunday morning, every Sunday night, every Wednesday night at church. And I love these new praise choruses that they're singing at these new churches on the wall, you know. Those are nice, but I love the old hymns of the church, the ones that are still in that red book. See, I was born and raised in Cleveland, Tennessee. That's where that red book was made. Of course, it's a Church of God book. You didn't know that, did you? I'm the only Baptist in Cleveland, Tennessee. Everything else is Church of God. When they go to heaven, they got to go through Cleveland to get there. But my church... I was born and raised on that red book. Number 112 was one of my favorites, and then Victory in Jesus. But I love the old songs. Those are the ones that have made it and ones that have lasted through the years. They're just as good now as they were when they were written hundreds of years ago. And I did a project a couple of years ago that's still one of the most popular projects on our table. 73 minutes long, continuous medley of nothing but hymns. Just a piano and a hymn book, no orchestra, no choir. It's called The Story.